Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Valeria or Fluorescent Suvi over here. Today I want to do something a little bit more different. So I have actually a bullet journal. I was thinking of this concept instead of doing hauls, like big hauls, I would do monthly hauls. I wrote down everything for the month of June and I have it right here. So I have the prices and I have what I wrote. I know it's a full page, it's long. And I just want to be more aware of what I'm buying and what I'm using and if I'm using it or not. And that gives me the whole time since I've bought it to the end of the month to give you like a review of the products I have. So if you really like this concept that I created, please let me know. Give me a thumbs up on the videos. And we're just going to get started to see what I bought makeup wise for the month of June. I don't have the dates, but one of my biggest purchases for the beginning of the month was actually from Sephora. I actually bought this Autres Couture Diamond Glow Powder in the shade Conceited. Now, I am gonna go get it changed because I do really like it, but it is too dark for me. I am not tan enough and I think it just kind of gives me like a dark hue instead of like highlighting my face all the way, but it is very beautiful. Next thing is foundation. I actually bought this because I remember my cousin saying that she loved this foundation. She thought it was really nice and I just was so stuck on it and it took me so long. Honestly, it's been like 2 years since she recommended me this foundation and I just never got around for it. So I actually went and bought it because I do like the other NARS foundation that I have. And I was just like, you know what? I really want to try the Sheer Glow. I want to see the difference between both of them. There's a big difference, but together they look so beautiful. I think for like combination skin, the NARS, this is the Sheer Glow, and then the Radiant, Longwear Radiant Foundation, together just make you last all day and you look good. So this foundation is really nice, and this is my summer shade in the shade Stromboli. Now, I'm a huge fan of bronzer, so the next thing I bought was the Too Faced Sweetheart Bronzer, which is this like baked luminous bronzer. I am a huge shimmery bronzer type bitch. I do have a video where I use most of my products, and so just stay tuned because I know I haven't posted it yet. But yeah, this is beautiful and I have no regrets on purchasing this. Okay, so the next thing I actually got was this Claudier Spritz Beauty Elixir, and I always get the mini just because it's $15 and I really think that the big one is like 50 bucks, so I can never make myself buy that because it's just so big. I only use this for the mornings. I know the tab is coming off, but I can't fix it, but whatever, it still works. And I only use this in the mornings and I really focus it on my eyes and my nose just because I feel like it just wakes me up and just the smell of it is like, it smells so like therapeutic because Sephora has a lot of points. They always have a lot of free shit. So one of the things I actually decided to get was the Gimme Brow in the shade number 3. This is perfect. I actually have it on right now, my eyebrows. I think this is the perfect shade for my eyebrows, especially because I have blonde hair now. I think it looks so natural. I use this every day for work and I think this is perfect for every day. It is one of the easiest steps to do because you just comb over your brows and you are done. I went into Morphe and I bought just one thing just because Jeffree Star actually came out with the gloss. The shade I have is Shockwave. I really do like this gloss. This gloss is very pretty. I've used it only once in a video as well, coming soon. And I thought it looked so pretty with the look. So this is really cute. I really do like this. So then a couple days later, I actually went to Ulta and did a big haul there too. That was more of a drugstore haul because I was looking for stuff for the summer that I can use every day. One of the first things I bought was the e.l.f. Aqua Primer Mist. I really do like this. I have combination skin where I don't like to go full matte all over my face. I do prefer to just put on my T-zone. And this was perfect to put after I did my foundation. Like, I use this as a setting spray. I do like it. It does hydrate. It does make your skin feel really refreshing. So I have no complaints about this. Oh, also, I actually finished this, so I need to re-up on another one. Okay, so the next thing I actually bought was my AHA BHA Clarifying treatment toner from COSRX. Now this, as you can tell, I've been using a lot of it, and I'm not a fan because it is a, like, it is a spraying mist, and I'm not a fan of that with tone. It is a toner. I prefer to put in a cotton swab and then put it all over my face. So this is not my favorite. I'm just gonna finish it up, and then I probably won't repurchase this. I don't see a big difference. That's why I wouldn't repurchase it. I got the NYX Dewy Finish setting spray. The reason why I do that, I bought this, is because I actually use this to wet my brushes. I don't like to use my Max Fix Plus. I feel like Max Fix Plus is way too expensive to be wasting it like that, so I rather use this than anything else. And this makes your skin feel hydrated too, so I might just put it on my everyday vanity, which is in my bathroom, and just use it up if I really want to. So yeah, that's why I bought it, because I was out of it. If you've been watching my videos from the beginning, you know that Milani's Baked Bronzer in Dulce is my ride or die. I fucking love this bronzer. I actually bought this bronzer because I was like, I need a bag. I love this for every day. I think it's so beautiful. It's a little bit shimmery, and it's just, it gives you that sheen. It's not even like shimmery. It gives you that beautiful sheen and bronzy look to your face. So I really do love it. Once I finish up my Too Faced matte bronzer, I'm gonna put this in my everyday makeup vanity. This is gonna be repurchased till the day I die, because I love this. Okay, last two things from my Ulta purchase. So the first thing I got is actually my Milani Prime Protect SPF 30 face primer. So because it is the summer, I do tend to work a lot outside, and I think this is really nice to have as a SPF on my face, just because I do go out a lot. So this is the reason why I bought it. I wanted to try it out. I do think it looks very nice. It feels very moisturizing, so I don't mind it. And I like to use this when I forget to put my actual SPF, like a moisturizer, on. So I'm like, oh shit, I forgot it. So I put this on, and you know, it's completely good. What I did learn recently is that it doesn't matter how many SPF products you have, it won't accumulate everything. It will just use, it's like using one product. So I like to use this, as like I said, when I forget to put my SPF everywhere else, I'm like, shoot, I need to do it all over my face. I use this. This is my backup. This is really nice. I think this would be perfect if you are out in the, like if you're going to a pool or if you're going to the beach. I think this is perfect because you can reapply it. And if you do feel like your skin's getting very dry, this is very moisturizing. So I really like this primer. It's very nice, and it's drugstore, so no complaints about that. This is the Body Shop Tea Tree Oil, and this is actually used for spot treatments. I was recently having a lot of breakouts throughout my face, and they were hormonal, and they were because, I hate to say this, but because I was drinking so much fucking coffee, like Starbucks coffee. And I think it's because they used the 2% milk that it's been fucking with my skin. I went 40 days without going because of Lent. I stopped drinking Starbucks, and my skin was the clearest. And then I started drinking again, and my skin was, I mean, I'm pretty sure you can see from my last video how many like red spots I was having. Like, I had really bad acne. So I decided to cut Starbucks out of my life. And if you know me in real life, you know I had fucking caramel frap every single fucking day. Now I don't. And it breaks my heart. I do think this is perfect for breakouts. It has like a little topper where you can't overuse it. So all you do is put a Q-tip on it, and then you let the actual treatment go down the Q-tip, and then you just spot conceal. And I really like this because it's not like you're using it as a mask. I feel like you can put it right before you put makeup on, so it gives you like an extra protection, so it doesn't clog your pores even more. I don't use it as much anymore because I obviously not breaking out as bad, but it's good to have in, you know, in your bathroom. I did go back to Ulta. I'm always at Ulta, I know. But I did go back to Ulta, and I was actually looking for setting sprays because, I don't know, I just want to find some like drugstore setting spray that is good, and I don't have to use my Urban Decay ones and waste my for every day. I just want to find one that I can use every day and not spend as much. So I actually found this Ofra Makeup Fixer, and this is a setting spray. This is $16. $12, and you get more product than the Morphe one. The Morphe one is $12, but you get like only 0.8 fluid ounces, and this one you get, oh, you get 8 fluid ounces. So you can see that's a big difference. You get a lot of product for your money. I still haven't transferred it to my everyday makeup vanity just because I am trying to finish up the Morphe one first. But when I have used it, I do really like it. Now, the next product is actually my NYX Honey Do Me. This product, again, was recommended by my same cousin that recommended me this. She actually recommended me these two products at the same time. And I don't know why, I always forgot about this one, but I never forgot about the foundation. And she's like, she has I think she has more oily skin than me, and especially in the T-zone. And she was like, yeah, I feel like this actually works for my skin. I feel like it lasts all day. And I'm not gonna lie, it feels really nice. I do think this this primer feels so good on like normal to combination skin, maybe even dry skin, because it's just so hydrating. And it's kind of like a weird texture because it's very gooey. It's very gooey, but honestly, I think it feels very nice in my skin. I feel like it doesn't make me feel like tacky to the point where I'm uncomfortable. I think this is very hydrating and very nice. So I do like this, and I'm gonna keep on using it for sure. Sometimes I'm guilty of buying makeup in the TJ Maxx side. I don't care. I love it. If you can get something half off, why not? And sometimes the things are discontinued or they're there for a reason. And to be honest with you, it's like a hit or miss, but I don't mind it because you get discounts on it. So the first thing I actually got was the Becca Glow Gloss in the shade Rose Gold. I actually used it in the video, and I used these two bad boys together, which is the Jeffree Star Shockwave and this one. So I have no complaints about this. This is actually a really nice shade, and the formula is very nice. It's not sticky. I am not sensitive to, I don't mind if it's sticky or not. I feel like I can wear any type of lip gloss and be comfortable. So yeah, I like this one. Sometimes I do notice that TJ Maxx has Japanese like brushes, really good brushes there. And Japanese is actually one of the brands that I really do like. I love their foundation brush. Oh, this is a must-have duo baking, and I honestly don't use this for baking. I actually use this for cream contour just so I can bring up my cream contour for my bronzer. And for this one, I actually used to prime my lids. And I think these are perfect. I think these are really nice. I got these for $14, and I think they go up in the 20 range in at Ulta. So I think this was like a good combo. So yeah, these are really nice, and I'm really glad I bought these at TJ Maxx. Then again, I went back to Sephora a couple days later, and I actually have been in the hunt for this product. This is the Cover FX Cheek Duo Blush in the shade Warm Honey. Now, these two are so beautiful. Oh my gosh, this is way too pigmented to just, if you just barely tap it, and you'll have like a very harsh blush. So be very careful. But I love combining this into, like, this is such a beautiful shimmery bronze. I feel like you can tell right there. And for my skin tone, I think this is really pretty. I do want to get the peach one. I feel like it might be a little bit too light, but I feel like I can still make it work. So I was so excited for this. I've been on a hunt looking for them, and everybody was telling me that these were only online, and I was so sad because I don't like shopping online. I prefer just to pick it up right then and there, and I was able to find it on a Sephora JCPenney, so I was super fucking stoked. And this was the only color available, and I was shocked, but I'm shocked that this is, you know, this was there and I was able to get it. So yeah, I really like this product. The next thing I got was this Colorful Shadow and Liner Waterproof, and it's in this very cool fresh, the shade is called Fresh Lemonade. It's like this chartreuse green. I hate myself because the first thing I did was when I opened it, I literally sliced it open. So it's already fucking butchered, as you can see right there. But I was like, I don't care, I'm gonna make it work. I'm not gonna just throw that away. This was actually on clearance for $7. They're usually $14. I actually really find it interesting, and I'm going to use it soon for a 3-in-1 looks palette. So stay tuned. Okay, so I went back to Morphe just because Morphe came out with the Jawbreaker collection. This is so fucking beautiful. I haven't even opened it. I haven't even touched it. Or actually, I've opened it, but I haven't touched the eyeshadows yet because I do want to make a video about it. So here's the palette right here. It's a pretty pink with green. And these are the eyeshadows, and oh my god, I love that the mirror bends back because most of the time I do have a big mirror in front of me, so I don't need this, but it's so beautiful. And honestly, I was so convinced by this row right here, the second row, just because of how like pastel it is. And oh my god, I'm dying, I'm living for it. I really love this delicious color. When I saw the swatch video, I was like, all right, bitch, I'm getting this, and I'm sold. I love this. I think it's a really beautiful, colorful palette that is different than a rainbow palette, if that makes sense. I think you just get so many different shades, and it's beautiful. I'm probably going to film that video next because I need to get my life together, and I need to post it ASAP. Okay, so I got two Velour Liquid Lipsticks, and I love the packaging. I do not want to throw these away because they're just chartreuse lime green, or this chartreuse color is my favorite. Oops. It is beyond beautiful, and I'm obsessed with it. Now, the two lip colors that I got were the Bronze Blood and the No Offense shade. Now, for this, I'm thinking about doing like a graphic lip liner with this once I do the look. So I'm just so excited. I love the funky colors. I think this is going to be a beautiful lip topper and kind of to mix it in with a lipstick. So that's why I really got it, because just because of that, I can envision like a very pretty rose gold type of lip, and it's just gonna look so beautiful. So yeah, so that's why I got it. But yeah, this is these two I'm fucking excited for, and they're going back in their box until I use them, because last time what I did for the Fenty eyeliners, I threw the boxes away, and I was so unprofessional. I was like, why didn't I think of this, and I need them for an actual video. So yeah, they're going back in their box, and they're being safe, and they're gonna look pretty until I use them. Okay guys, because the Morphe store is right next, it's like super close to the Sephora store, I obviously had to make a pit stop to Sephora. Like, I can't disrespect Sephora like that. And I actually got the Sephora All Day Hydrator. I got a sample of this, and I kid you not, it is like the most hydrating thing, and it makes my skin feel so plumped and so hydrated. It's a hydrator, that's all it does, it hydrates your skin. Now what I like to do is I like to use this after I use my essence, and then I go in with this hydrator to just hydrate my skin even more. And let me tell you, I don't know, my skin just feels so good. I feel like this is perfect for all skin types. It helps everybody, it hydrates everybody, and you need this in your life. And it's $16, it's super inexpensive. Sephora Collections is such an underrated brand. I got two samples with the same purchase. I actually got my Clinique Venosource Moisturizer, and I got the serum, which is the Radiance Serum. These are bomb. These are so, okay, Claudia is so fucking expensive that it hurts my wallet, but anytime I see them too, you're like, oh, these are 100 points, do you want any of them? I say, bitch, give me two of them if I can afford them, because these are so good. I got two of these, and I got two of these in my everyday vanity in my bathroom. So my camera rudely interrupted me and just turned off on me, and oh shit, it actually died. This battery's dying too. Fuck. Okay, let's just get started. Get over with this. The reason why I actually like to get a lot of sample moisturizers is because with my unit, sometimes I'm gone and I leave out of state, and I'm gone from my house for like multiple days. So instead of getting something like this big, I actually take a lot of sample sizes with me to travel, and I think it is perfect. I think like it's so much easier for me to travel with these things than like full-size products, and that's why I really like stocking up on these. So yeah, this is why I always pick them up. This is the end of the video. Now I have a very, very serious question for you guys. If you guys made it this long, I need your guys' help. I am for sure going to keep on writing all of my monthly purchases and everything that I buy and the prices. Now I need your guys' help to see if you guys want more details. So one of the things is, do you guys want the prices, me telling you the prices? Do you want me to tell you what day I went and of the month so then you can see? Is that important? Is that not important? Let me know. Comment down below. Also, one of the most important things right now is, do you guys prefer to see this the end of the month, the last day of the month, or do you prefer to see it in the first day of the next month? So for June's monthly hauls, do you prefer to see it July 1st or do you prefer to see it June 30th, if that makes sense? Please comment down below. Let me know, because that would help me out a lot. This is a new concept I came up with, and I love buying makeup and I love kind of like talking about it and just being able to be like, this is what I bought and what do you think, and are you thinking about getting them, and if it catches your interest. Like, hauls are my favorite, but I don't shop at a bulk. I shop like little things every other day, you know, every other week. It's mainly when I'm off. That's honestly how I do my shopping. It's like on Tuesdays and Wednesdays is when I go shopping. Yeah, guys, let me know what you guys think. If you guys like this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed to my channel, subscribe. You guys are for sure going to see more of these monthly hauls. I'll talk to you guys later and I'll see you in my next video. Bye, guys.